What's up, everybody? I am pretty pumped today. Thank you for joining me. I'm George. This is Marvelous Statues, the show where we get to unbox and review some of the coolest statues and collectibles known to man. And today, I am at a journey's end, and I am stoked about it, man. This is the final piece of the Mythos Star Wars line, and what started out as just my first statue ever, thanks to my wife, has turned into a full set. I got every single one of them now, starting out with Vader, Obi-Wan, Boba Fett, Darth Maul, and now the Gamorrean Executioner, also known as Lomrock. So let's get him unboxed real quick. I'm stoked to see him. I can't wait to see him. And then we'll do a review. We'll get real close up and personal with him, do all the stuff that you know and you've come to expect from this channel. So let's get to it. There it is, Lomrock, Jabba's Gamorrean Executioner. So this is dope. Box art is just like all of the other Star Wars lines from Mythos. You got a statue right here of the character. And I like how they always have that gloss background, and then you have this matte black. So I think it's a real elegant looking box. Statue does a real good job with that. You got Jabba's eyes right there. And then you got what probably is the art print. So when we get that out, all of them come with that. And then here on the side, this guy here is Longo Two Guns, I think is what his name was. So I'll tell you a little bit more about this guy here in just a minute when we get the statue out, and I'll give you a backstory about who this dude is and why he's so special. So let's get him out. This is it, man. It's the final piece. Woo! All right. So looks like this has never been opened. No, it's been open. It's just he sealed it pretty good. So I want to give a big thanks to my man Chris, who hooked me up with this piece. Chris, if you don't know him, he is part of Level 52 Studios, and you know I'm always chucking up his work. Guy has some really awesome statues over there at Level 52. Mostly some Frank Frazetta stuff and some other statues that I really enjoy that they're doing. They have this really dope, Odin statue that I thought was really cool. And you guys should definitely head over to Level 52 Studios and go check that out, see their work. I think it's some amazing stuff they're doing there. So anyway, he contacted me because I was looking for this piece. And he says, George, I got what you're looking for, man. And I was like, what? He was like, yeah. So, man. Big thanks to him, man. We couldn't complete this without you, buddy. So thank you. Thank you so much. So anyway, here is your art print. So there you go. And then like I stated before, so this is Longo Two Guns, I think is what his name is. So if you played the video game Bounty Hunter, that's where he comes into play. So Lomrock is part of that era, part of right around Jango Fett's time, you know? And in that mission with Jango Fett, you hunt down this guy and you bring him to Jabba, and this is basically what happens to him afterwards. He has to deal with Lomrock the Executioner, and that's the deal with him. So let's put that back. I really dig that. I always like this about all of the Mythos statues. They give you the art print, and it sides as a certificate of authenticity. So it's always good stuff. And this is the most intact box that I've had since I got the Vader. All of the other ones have had some missing stuff in it. I think Maul actually was complete. Not missing parts, but you know, either missing the shipping box or something like that. All right, so let's get this guy out. Thank you. So let's let me get some pictures of it. Get up close and personal with it. Yeah. And then we'll do a review. All right. See you in a few. All right, guys, I'm back. Did all the close-up video, did some shots, photographs, everything I could to get up close and personal with this thing, studied it so I could give you guys my thoughts on this piece. And let me tell you, he does not disappoint at all. At all. This thing is dope. After Obi-Wan, I would say this is my favorite piece of the Mythos line. So let's get into who this guy is. So when I first saw the statue, I always thought that this guy was just another Gamorrean guard. You know, so it kind of fit in with the whole Return of the Jedi theme that most of the Mythos line had to deal with the older trilogies. And, you know, I felt that that fit in with it. But, you know, he's not a guy that you commonly see being made. And he definitely, the species is not somebody, not something that when I saw Return of the Jedi that I was like, oh man, you know, that guy's dope. I would love to own a figure of him. But I wanted to complete the Mythos line. So that was the first reason why I wanted to get this piece. But then I read about this guy's backstory and I was like, damn, this guy's actually kind of cool. So although the species is most associated with Return of the Jedi, Lomrock is not from the era of Return of the Jedi. So he is from the new trilogies or the old movies. So old movies is probably the bad way to say that. It's a new trilogy. So it's either episode 1, 2, and 3. So probably right around episode 1 and episode 2 was where this guy existed, that timeline. So around the time of Jango Fett, Darth Maul, that thing, you know, when the Republic was still together and when Emperor Palpatine first became Chancellor, somewhere around that time era. So Lomrock was a warlord and he decided to become a gladiator in Jabba's pit. So he graduated from that and then became the executioner. And he was the guy that used to kill everybody before Jabba got the Rancor. Now, there's nothing telling us what happened to him afterwards, why Jabba decided to go with the Rancor over Lomrock. I mean, I heard that he was pretty badass. He's bigger than any of the other Gamorreans. So, you know, he had an impressive size about him and everything. But, you know, maybe it was just the idea of having a Rancor. I mean, who would don't mess with the Rancor, right? Unless you're Luke Skywalker. All right, so now that we know a little bit about this character, let's get into the statue, and I'm going to tell you my thoughts, things I like about it, things that are a little problematic with the way it was put together, but it's all right. Overall, I think the statue was perfect. I'm really happy with it, so spoiler alert, I'm digging this piece a lot, so let's get into what this thing is. So just like all of the other Mythos lines, you have this very elegant, circular-looking base. Every single one of them has the identical looking sculpt for the bottom part of the base. They all just have a little bit different color theme to it. So this one here has more of a dark brown, which kind of puts it in the Jabba's Palace type of look, where you have Obi-Wan that has kind of like a sand-swept appeal to it. Vader has more of an Empire look. Still, I feel the king of the bases is Boba Fett. Boba Fett has that protruding stone that comes out of it, and he's kind of like standing on top of it, which I think is really, really cool. But this one here takes second best. I think this thing is dope. So of the only one, this is the only one of the Mythos line that actually has a piece that sits on top of the base, while the others are all kind of just the base itself, and then the statue sits up on top of that. The rock formation here at the bottom, which looks like Jabba's pit, is badass. It's very, you know, textured very nicely, has lots of nice color in it, has a lot of elaborate detail in there. So I think it makes it look very alive and has a lot of character to it. And then sitting on top of that is the skull of what looks like to be a Tauntaun, but on Tatooine they were called Koopas. So if you guys know from Hoth, the Tauntaun was the mount that Luke Skywalker was riding on and that, you know, he ultimately got stuffed inside of when Han saved them from the Wampa. So Koopas are the distant relative of that species. They look pretty much identical to a Tauntaun, but their skin tone is a little bit different and they're more adapt for the temperatures of Tatooine. So that's what this is. So you have this really awesome looking skull and it sits in there real nicely. Lots of nice texture work going on in there as well. Very beautiful looking paint job. So the only thing I had an issue with here was when I was trying to place it in, he doesn't sit in very well, this skull. doesn't actually go all the way down in, and maybe I need to push a little bit harder. But I felt like I gave it a lot of give to it. Just didn't seem to go down the way I thought it would. And the Gamorrean here, he kind of sits real close to it. So I couldn't figure out which one to put in first, you know. So I put in the skull first, and then you put in the Gamorrean, and then you have the axe. Or actually, you put the axe in, and then you have the Gamorrean sitting in there. So if you saw me put it together, you could see what I did. So Lomrock actually goes in last in this case, and it actually works. So looks real good. I love the way the axe is textured and detailed. Has lots of nice paint there. They have all kinds of breakage going on there. It looks like he's actually been used and beaten on. He's definitely done some killing with it. So really cool stuff. Lomrock himself looks fantastic. I mean, the paint job on him is outstanding. Lots of nice tones going all the way through it. So I think this thing is painted exquisitely. You know, you have these gnarly looking feet with these like little broken nails and everything. And it just has real nice color to it. It's got a gloss, but then it has like this yellow tone going on in it as well. So really cool. Very nice detail in the sandals that he's wearing. Really love the way the skin tone is painted. It's because you have all of these battle scars going on his body. And then you have these areas like in the knees, you know, where you would see more worn areas on his skin. And it has like a lighter green effect to it. So I think that came out really, really nice. So very cool. The sash that he's wearing here, or war skirt, we'll call it. I don't know what else to call it. It has very nice texture there, make it look like hair. So I think that's dope. I love how they put this skull there. I don't know what kind of animal that is, but I think it looks dope. It has a nice little effect and detail. And then all of the belts and buckles that they have going on, the little loops of metal, you know, and you go around the back and it has this garment that's sitting on top of that as well, or it's wrapped around the belt. Really nicely done, and it's painted very well to make it look like leather. So I think that's done very well also. So his muscles and fat, you know, are done very nicely. The sculpt is done good. You have all of this texture in the skin, which makes it look like it's got a tough texture to the skin, like what you see in the movies. So I think that's pretty deep, really, really neat. I mean, love the battle scars, you know. And I really think this tattoo that he has here on the right arm, that looks sick. That looks really cool. So very, very nice stuff that they got going on here. You know, you have these gauntlets that he's wearing, and they have this kind of like rusted appeal to it. So I think that's neat. I really like the way the hands are sitting on top of the axe, like he's balancing on it. Again, just like in the feet, the nails are painted very well. So you have this kind of like gloss, but they have two tones going on there, little dark and light tones on the nail. So I think that's dope. The portraits on both of these are outstanding. I think of the whole Mythos line, with the exception of Obi-Wan, like I said, I think the portraits on these are the best. I mean, they have a lot of character, and that's what I really like about it. Like this portrait here, it looks like he's almost burping or yelling or something, right? And you know, they did everything. They sculpted in the tongue, and you have all this really nice gloss on the inside. The teeth are showing, so I think that's really dope, you know. And then I love how the snout on the nose has got this gloss, you know, so it's like lots of wet and mucusy type of feel to that front of the nose. So I think that's really neat. The head sash that he's wearing, the head helmet, or I guess we'll call it, that has lots of nice texture. It looks like leather, you know, and they got all this metal appeal going on there and everything. Overall, I think this is dope, you know, and you can swap it out and you have this other head here, which he's a little more calm. And he looks like he's just sitting there looking you down, waiting to get his order to kill you. So I think that's dope too. I can't decide which head I like more. I'm probably going to go with the one with him yelling, is because I feel like it has the most character. But yeah, they both look really good to me. You know, I've heard from other collectors how the Gamorrean is the one to get. And having it in person, man, I have to agree with them. They were right. The Gamorrean is the best. It's wild looking, man. You know? And the fact that they don't make this character too often adds to it. You know, just adds to the appeal of this guy. It's a really awesome looking piece. So, very happy to get it. Thanks, Chris, again, for hooking me up with this. You know, if you guys are into the Mythos line, I'm going to do something for you guys right now. I'm going to pause this video. I'm going to get all of the Mythos statues out, and we're going to have them all spread out here on the table so you can see all of them up close and how they look together. All right, guys, there they are, the entire squad, all of them. This is they finally finished this. I'm really, really pumped that I was able to complete this. And, you know, thank you guys for coming along this journey with me to gather these statues, because this is one hell of a ride that I had to get them, man. It was a lot of fun, and I'm glad that I was able to show you guys all this and be able to share it with y'all. So, you know, I appreciate all the love and support you guys have been showing me, watching the videos, you know, laughing at my antics and everything, the wall crawls and all that. I'm going to be coming back at you with a lot of that, so definitely stay tuned. You know, I'm not done yet. So I appreciate you guys for hanging out with me. Please give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And if you're new here, hit subscribe. Ding that bell to become part of the notification squad. You can catch all of our videos at mcecentral.com. I'm going to be coming back at you with more videos just like this one. So stay tuned for all of that. And until next time, guys, keep it marvelous.